Hello, I am Vaishali. Today I am here with the topic of duality. The duality topic is studied under the subject operation research. Okay, so this is the another question on duality. So in this question, we are doing the comparison of primal and dual solutions. Okay, so the first question is, do the comparison of solution to the primal, this is the primal problem, and its dual, this is the given dual problem. Consider the following pair of LPP problem. So these are the two problems. One is the primal and its dual problem is written here. You have to find the solution and then you have to compare their solutions. The same question we can write in another way is to solve the following primal LPP and its dual. Okay, solve the following primal LPP and its dual by the simplex method. In this case, the primal is given, this primal is given, okay, then after that, dual you have to write yourself, first thing. Second thing, then you have to find the solution of both and then you have to compare. Let's see what it is written. This is the part of question. Verify the solution of primal can be read from the optimal table of the dual and vice versa. That means for that you have to solve both the problem, the primal and the dual individually, and then you have to read the solution of the primal and dual from the one table, then same you have to do from the another table. Also state the several steps involved in this process. Okay, so these both questions are same. Anyway, they can ask you, but you have to give the same answer. Now, I'll tell you how to solve this. First, the primal problem is already given. Okay, so in the primal problem, you know that when the problem is primal, you have to convert from primal to standard primal. Primal, then to dual. Like this we used to do. Okay, so here primal is given. Let's check for standard. What are the steps for standard? When the objective function of maximization, the constraint should be sign less than, and when the objective function of minimization, constraint should be sign greater than. So we have the objective function in maximum, okay, and the constraint of the sign less than. That means this is the standard primal. Now we have to write the steps for simplex. Okay, for first case, now start writing for the first case. This left side I am going to solve for primal and right side I am going to solve for the dual. Now start writing the steps for the simplex. Step number one, writing the problem into standard simplex form. What is that? First thing, the objective function should be maximization. Objective function is in maximization form. Then the constraint, right hand side constraint, should be of positive sign. So it is already there. Okay, after that we have to see the constraint. That means to convert the given inequality into equation. Okay, so this is with the sign less than. That means we have to add the slack variable. In these we have to add the slack variable. It will become 2x1 plus 3x2 plus 1s1. Then next one, 8x1 plus 4x2 plus 0s1 plus 1s2. We can write 0s2 here. Equal to 3, equal to 5. Then the objective function will be new objective function. Max of z x equal to 40 x1 max of zx equals to 40x1 plus 50x2 plus 0s1 plus 0 of s2. Okay, so this is the new objective function. Fine. Now after that, we have to solve this by the help of the simplex table. Okay, now step number 2, solving by simplex table or simplex method. Fine. Now first I'll tell you how to solve this section, then we'll move to the dual. Now this is the step number 2, simplex table for primal. Okay, simplex table for primal. Now you know very well this is the section for basic variable. Okay, I'm writing it in abbreviated form. Then CB, then XB, then CJ, then delta J, then Z. I think you understand this because I have solved many questions for simplex. Now the decision variables involved are x1, x2, s1, s2. Here s1 and s2 we are going to write because these are the basic variables. Then CB should be, first we write CJ. CJ are the coefficient and the objective function. It will become 40, 50, 0 and 0. Okay. Then now writing the values here. CB 0, 0. Then for XB, right hand side constant 3, 5. Then here we have to write value from this section. Under X1 we have to write 2, 3. Under X2, 3, 4. Under S1, 1, 0. Under S2, 0, 1. Now start solving this. Okay, value of Z is CB into XB, 0 into 3, CB into XB is the value of Z. So 0 into 3 plus 0 into 3, oh sorry, 0 into 5, it will become 0, 0. Then CB into X, then we have to find the value of delta J. What is delta J? Delta J is CB into XJ minus of CJ. It is 0 into 2 plus 0 into 3 minus of 40. So it will become 0 minus 40. It will become minus of 40. Okay. So it will become minus of 40. Similarly, when there are both the zeros, so we can directly write the minus sign before the above CJ values. And this will become the value of delta J. So 0 and 0. So delta J, what is the incoming vector? Incoming vector is minimum of delta J. So what are the values of delta J? Minimum of minus 40, minus 50, 0 and 0. So minimum is minus 50. That means minus 50, X2 is incoming vector. So this column will be the key column. Then for outgoing vector, it is minimum of XB upon XJ. J is for the number of the key column. That means 2 is the J. J equal to 2. That means minimum of XB upon X2. It is minimum of 3 by 3 or 5 by 4. So it will, this one is the minimum. We write it here in this side. XB upon XJ, that means 3 by 3 and 5 by 4. So this is the minimum one. Okay. So S1 will be the outgoing vector. This is the pivot element. Pivot element we have to make at 1. We have to make as 1 and the remaining in the column as 0. So start solving it. S1 will be replaced by x2, then s2, okay. Then value of x2 is 50, s2 is 0. Then dividing throughout by 3 we get as 1, okay. Then this we have to multiply from here to here by 4. So that we can subtract this from this, this row by this row, okay. So we get 0 here. Start solving it, we get 1, 16 by 3, 0, minus 4 by 3, 1. We have applied operation in R2, this one R2 and R1. What I had done, 4 of R2, R1 minus 4 of R2, I have written in the R1, R2. This I have applied in the second row. Okay. So what is now when filling all the values, value of Z will become CB into XB. 50 into 1 is 50. 0 into 1 is 0. So 50. Then delta J. Delta J is CB into XJ minus of CJ. That means 50 into 2 by 3 minus 40. Minus 20 by 3, then 50 into 1 is 50, minus 50 is 0, 50 into 1 by 3 is 50 by 3, then minus 0, 50 by 3, then 50 into 0 is 0, 0 into 1 is 0, it will become 0. Then this is most negative, no need to find for delta j because only 1 is negative, so this is the smallest one, that means x1 will be the incoming vector. Now for XB upon XJ. So XB upon X1 now we have to do for this case. That means 1 into 3 by 2 and then 1 into 3 by 16. So this one will be the outgoing vector because this is the minimum one. Okay. So then we are joining the line like this and like this. This will be the pivot element. We have to convert it into the 1. Now again writing for this x2, s2 will going to replace by x1, 50, x1 value is 40, then dividing throughout from here from xb column to xs2 by 3 by 16, multiply by 3 by 16 so that we obtain this as 1. Now 3 by 16, then 1, then 0, then 1 by 16. Then 3 by 16, okay, 1 by 4 we get, here it is 4 by 3, when we multiply by 3 by 16, it will means 1 by 4 we get, minus of 1 by 4, then here we have to apply the operation, we have to multiply this line, we want this should be 0. So that means we have to multiply this by 2 by 3. That means we have to multiply throughout by 2 by 3. Then we can subtract this to obtain it as 0. Okay. So what I am going to do is this line. This one. This full line. That means this is, if I will say this is R2, I will multiply R2 by 2 by 3. And if this is R1, I will subtract it R1. And we put the value in R1, which you do in the matrix in your 12th class. The same you have to do in here. The transformation, you have to apply the application to change the values of row. Okay. So when we multiply throughout by 2 by 3, we get 2 by 3 here, then we minus this by this, we get 0. So applying the application, we get the value as 7 by 8, 0, then 1, then 1 by 2, then 1 by 8. After getting values, we have to find the value of Z. That means 50 CB into XB, 50 into 7 by 8 plus 40 into 3 by 16. The value is 205 by 14. Okay, 205 by 205 by 4. We get this 205 by 4. Start writing here 205 by 4. Solve it and get the value CB into XB. We get 205 by 4. Now after that we have to check for delta J. Values of delta J will be 50 into 0 is 0, 40 into 1 is 1. That means 40 into 1 is 40 minus 40. It is 0. Then 50 minus 50 is 0. Then it will become 15. It will become 5 by 4. So these are positive. So these are the value. Now writing the solution. Primal. Solution of primal. What is the solution of primal? Zx equal to 2 by 5 by 4. Okay, then 2 by 5 by 4, then x1 equal to 3 by 16. You know that this is the place where we get the solution for x1, and from here we get the solution for x2. So x2 equal to 7 by 8. This is the answer for primal. This is the answer for primal. Now after this, if you remember, we have left the portion for dual. Now we have to solve for dual. Okay, now for dual we have to see the same problem, this section. The dual is already given. You have to write, you have to check for standard dual, and then you have to check for standard simplex. Okay. Now here we have to write the step number 1. This is the portion I am doing for dual problem. Okay, this is a minimization form with the sign greater than. So this is the standard dual form. Okay, then step number 1, convert the problem into its standard simplex form. Okay, standard simplex form. Now start converting it. If you remember, we are doing this question. We are having two problems. One is in primal form, other is in dual form. We have solved the half section here on the left hand side. Then we have solved for simplex. Now we are jumping to dual. We are solving it on right hand side. Okay, now writing the standard simplex form. That means step number 1 here, convert the minimization objective function into the maximization. So for that, minimum of ZW equal to 3W1 plus 5W2, that means subtracting both the side, multiplying both the side by minus 1. It will become max of Z dash W equal to max of ZW with minus sign equal to minus 3W1 minus 5W2. This is the objective function in max form. Okay, then right hand side constants are positive, so no need to do that, no need to change. Then second one is to convert the less than sign into the greater than sign. Convert inequality into equation. Okay, convert inequality into the equation. So here inequalities, if you remember, is inequalities with the sign greater than equal to, then that means surplus and artificial variable will be added. Okay, surplus and artificial variable will be added. Now start adding the variables. I'll just fold it so it will easy for you to see. So this is the inequalities. It will become 2W1 plus 8W2 minus 1S1 plus 1A1. Then next one, 3W1 plus 4W2 plus 0S1 plus 0A1 minus 1S2 plus 1A2. It will become 50. 0S1 S2 plus 0A2, it will become 40. So these are the two equations. Okay, so this is the primal section. This is the dual section. If you want, you can write it here. Primal section. Then dual section. Okay, this is the primal section and this is the dual section. Primal we have already done. We are working for the dual. Now after this, write the new objective function. New objective function is max of z dash w equal to, from here, equal to minus 3w1 minus 5w2 plus this. I am going to solve by big M method because there is the presence of artificial variable. So I am applying the big M method. Coefficient of s1 s2 will become 0, 0 s1 plus 0 s2, and for artificial variable minus m. Please watch my previous videos for big M method. I am going to give the link below. Okay, for big M, this is the simplex we have applied, the simplex method, because in primal section there is the presence of slack variable. In dual section there is the presence of surplus and artificial. So we can solve it by two phase method also, or you can apply the big M method. I am applying the big M method. If you feel two phase easy, you can go with two phase also. The answer will, you will get the same if you are going to solve correctly. Okay, so here I am applying the big M method because I got the presence of artificial variable. Here I have applied the simplex one. Hope you understand this, what I mean to say. Now solving this section dual one, so we want the simplex table. So this is the simplex table for primal. Now step number one, we are doing the step number one. Now step number two is simplex table. This question is bit long. Earlier I was thinking whether I should solve it or not, but I thought to tell you one so that it will easy for you and you understand how we can compare both the solutions by different tables, by primal table and by dual table. Okay, so this is my main aim while solving this question. Second is simplex table for dual. This video will become bit long, so please support this video and see and try to understand this. So simplex table for dual. Now start writing. Basic variable, then CB, then XB. This is the section for CJ. These are the values we have used. Variable, W1 variable, then W2, then S1, then S2, then A1, then A2. Then value of CJ you get in objective function. This is the objective function. Okay, so the value is minus 3, minus 5, 0, 0, minus m, minus m. Okay, then you know that artificial and surplus we write under the section of basic variable for the first row. So no slack is there, only artificial we have to write, a1, a2. Okay, the values of CB will be minus m. For XB, equations we want this. 40 and 50. Okay, now for this section under W1 we will write 2, 3, then W2 8, 4, then for S1 minus 1, 0, for S2 minus 1, 0, for A1 1, 0 and 0, 1. Okay, now no need of this, start solving. So for that, what is the value of z is CB into XB. Now I am not telling in detail. I'll take it bit in hurry because it will become very lengthy and you also get bored. Okay, now I think you have seen my previous videos, so you understand big M well. So CB into XB, that means minus M into 40, minus 50 into M. That means 40M, 50M. So it will become minus 90M. Okay, this is minus 90M. Then delta j,
CB into W1 minus of CJ. So it will become minus 2M minus 3, and that means minus 5M plus 3. So it will become 3 minus 5M. Then it will become minus 8M minus 4M, that means 12M minus 12M. So 5 minus 12M. So it will become minus M minus M, that means plus M and 0, only M. Then it will become M, then it will become plus M minus M 0, then minus M plus M 0. So most negative will be this 12M, because this is minus 12M. Any quantity you can add, so this will become the smallest one. So W2 will be the incoming vector, and this is the column. Then after that, this will be WB. WB upon WJ. Okay, hope you understand this. So WB upon WJ, that means 40 upon 8 and 50 by 40. So which is the smallest one? 40 by 8 and 50 by 4. So this is the smallest one, A1. So we got this as pivot element. And now the same time, A1 is outgoing, that means cut this line. No need to solve A1 further. Okay. Now A1 will be replaced by W2, then A2 will remain same. Value of W2 is minus 5, then for A1 is minus M. Divide throughout by 8, what we get? 5, 1 by 4, 1 minus 1 by 8, 0 and 0. Similarly, this we want to make 0, so that means we have to multiply throughout by 4 so that we can subtract this R2 minus R1. We get 0 here. So I am writing the value 30, 2, 1 by 2, minus 1 and 1. Now start solving for Z. Z is equals to 25 minus 25 and minus 30 M. That means minus 25 minus 30 M. Okay. So this is the Z. Now for delta J, CB into W1 minus of CJ. So it will become 7 by 4 minus 2M. I am solving it directly. You solve it, otherwise it will take so much time, as I have solved many videos on this earlier. So it will become 0 minus M. Minus M and plus M is 0. So which one is the most negative? Most negative is this one. This is minus 2. This is minus M by 2. This is most negative, then that means W1 is the incoming vector. This is the key column. Then WB upon WJ. So that means 5 into 4 by 1 and 30 by 2. That means this one will be going as outgoing vector. So W2, A1 is replaced by W1 minus 5. W1 is minus 3. Then this should be 1 and the remaining is 0. Okay. So what the value I got, I write the values directly, because my main aim is to tell you the comparison of the solution. It is going very long. 3 by 16, 1 by 4, 1 by 8. Now no need to solve this. Then 1 by 2. Now this I wrote the value directly. Value of Z is same. Minus 5 into 5 by 14 minus 3 into 15. So we get minus 205 by 4. Then this into this we get the value of delta J. What is the delta J? 0, 0, 3 by 16 and 7 by 8. So this is all our positive. This is optimal solution. Do it quickly. Solution of dual. Solution of dual is ZW is equals to minus 205 by 4. This is Z dash, if you remember. Because we have, what we have done? This is Z dash in dual section. So we can write it as ZW equal to 205 by 4 by multiplying both the side by minus 1. Okay. Then W1 is 15 and W2 is 5 by 4. Okay. Now this is the dual. This is the solution for the dual. Then this is the solution for the primal.
This is the solution for the primal. Now my main aim is starts from here. To compare the both the solutions. This is the solution for primal. This is the solution from dual. See, the solution of primal in the table, the solution of primal, you will get the solution of dual from the last two or three values depending on the variable you have. In this is the primal simplex table. Please see clearly. This is the primal simplex table. This is the dual simplex table. In the dual, you are having only two variables, W1 and W2 as the decision variables. The remaining are the added one. Okay. So, the last two values will give you the solution for the dual. Okay. 15 and 5 by 4. Now, checking here. We get W1 as 15 and W2 by 5 by 4. So, now this is correct. Now, vice versa. This is the dual. In the dual table, last two values will give you the solution for the primal. Will give you the solution for the primal. That is 3 by 16 and 7 by 8. Checking here. Primal. 3 by 16 and 7 by 8. So, you got it? In the dual, we get the solution for the primal. And in primal, we get the solution for the dual. Okay. So, my main aim is to make you understand. When you compare the questions, do the comparison of solution. So, you have to solve the questions by this way. Okay. Please like, subscribe and share my channel. Hope you understand this video. This video is a bit lengthy because question demand is to solve both the problems separately. Okay. Thank you guys.